So I'm doing a test to see if the return to home actually comes back to the GPS location it took off from, or if it's seeking the radio, because somebody's trying to tell me that it seeks the radio, so, or transmitter. We'll see. Pretty windy today. Well, as you can see, it just took off, you know, right where the walkway is. So I will take it down here. Now I'm going to walk over here a little bit. See where it lands. Does it land there, or does it come back to where the radio is, transmitter is? Well, halfway between me and the takeoff location. Huh. Let's try it again. I'll go a little further. Okay, now I'm gonna walk a little further. Okay, as you can see, it landed pretty much pretty close to where it took off, within a few feet. I've seen it be as much as 5 feet off, but it usually comes back to where it should be. I'll try this again. Gonna stand right here. Okay, now I'm gonna walk down this way. Should land over there. So as you can see, it's really landing where the GPS location is that it took off from. And this, I mean, looks like it can be a few feet off, but this is pretty much spot on. Now I'll try being here to make sure it's not coming back to the transmitter location, because I was there when it took off, where the walkway is. As you can see, I'm right where this crack is. There's the crack here. Put it over here, put it up. Oh. I turned it a little bit back, so. All right, now, does it land here or does it land there? I'll go over here. So, as you can see, it really is using the GPS location it took off from, not the transmitter. Because it came back, it took off right there. It's always a few feet off. Because GPS, if you ever looked at GPS on a phone, where you're tracking somebody else's phone or something, it's never spot on. And I got 16 satellites. You know, we have wind, we have atmospheric conditions. We just had a storm that blew through. I can see where it can be a few feet off, but that's pretty damn good. pretty close to where it was. Let's try it again. I can see that auto landed because the battery is low. It's blinking red. I didn't do nothing on that time. It just auto landed right in the same place. That's a pretty good test. The XIANG F09-S Jayhawk GPS helicopter. It's a really, really good helicopter, easy to fly. You just gotta be really careful about where it takes off from. Because if you are standing, say, the helicopter, say, right here. Say this helicopter takes off from right here, it could land on the roof of the pit area. So you do have to, because that's about 3 feet. I've seen it be about three to five feet off. So yeah, very well.